Welcome to 7-3-4 Games, and this is Game Time, and this is your host, Tom. And before I get started with my final thoughts on Vampire, I would like to tell you that my nephew is getting cancer treatments. His GoFundMe is in the description. If you're watching this on BitChute, any money you give to this channel will go to that. And check out the GoFundMe. You can give him give money there. Thank you. Now let's get started. So let's get started with Vampire. Now, Vampire is a semi-open world, Dark Souls-ish. I wouldn't say it's a Souls-like. I would say Souls-ish action game where you play as a vampire, a newly turned vampire. Now, the gameplay is kind of weird because you think that a vampire would get more points for killing other vampires rather than, you know, saving people, you know, as a doctor, saving people's lives. But actually, he gets more points for saving lives, and you get a lot more points for finishing missions and doing events. So you want to do that when you're playing Vampire. If you want to level up, that is the best way to level up in the gameplay. The gameplay is actually a lot of fun, but if you're somebody who's not looking for that type, doesn't like that sort of soulsish combat because maybe it's too difficult, you can play the game in story mode. And that is not a bad option if you're someone who enjoys a good story, but you don't want hard gameplay or you don't want hard boss battles. Although I wouldn't say this game is anywhere near as hard as a lot of those other games like Souls or the Soulsborne series or even Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. It's nothing like that. So let me just tell you why you may want to, the story, tell you about the story. And that's why you may want to play this game in story mode if you don't like hard action games. Now, as far as the story is concerned, if you are a fan of Vampire Masquerade, the tabletop RPG, or any of the other content from that series, you're going to love Vampire. Vampire is kind of like, it's almost canon. It's kind of like what Lady Hawk was to the Dungeons & Dragons, and I said that in another video. And the story, as far as the developer, this developer, Dontnod, tells a great story. They did Remember Me, and they did the two of the Life is Strange games. There was the two main Life is Strange games were done by Dontnod. That was their series. They did them for Square Enix. There was a standalone. There was another one done by another developer that wasn't Dontnod, and I didn't even pick that one up. But Dontnod, Remember Me had a great story, and Life is Strange had a great story. This developer is known for great story, great voice acting, great presentation. So, and this game is no exception to that. So you may want to check out Vampire for the story alone, even if you're not a fan of the Souls-likes. Like I said, you can play it in story mode and totally enjoy this game. This game has, like I said, if you like Vampire Masquerade, then this is definitely the game for you. Now, so as far as my final thoughts on Vampire, I gotta say that this is a really well-done game. In a lot of ways, it kind of reminds me of Dishonored, as in, the things you do throughout this world really affect how the game goes and how the story, you know, moves along in this game. So you're going to enjoy that. If you like games where you can really affect the outcome of the story or the world around you, then you're going to like Vampire. It's not one of those games where everything depends on the last, you know, 30 seconds and that's the ending you get. No, your actions throughout the game will affect the world in this game. And I really enjoyed that about Vampire. And I would just say this is a game that if you are a fan of good stories, then you definitely want to pick this game up. And while this game will have a hard time competing with the big players out there, like the Horizon Zero Dawns and the Death Strandings, and, you know, just the big games like the, you know, just the really big games, the AAA games like Doom Eternal, this game is still definitely worth a playthrough. And I'm going to have to say, my final thoughts on this game is that this is definitely a game that you should pick up. Now, it was free on PlayStation. I have the PC version. I got the GOG version. And that's the version I like. And Vampire is definitely worth your time. It has, you have a lot of, you know, different ways you can go throughout the game. Different leveling trees. And there's one option, too, as you can basically start all over with your leveling tree without, basically you take it, what you do is you have you keep your points, but you erase your leveling tree and start all over, and you can level up your character, in a different way if you want to, fight, in a different manner throughout the game. Now, the only thing is, like, after you get to a certain area, after you do a certain quest, you're not going to be able to find another other quest to get more points. So you definitely want to be careful on what quest, because I played the game in hard mode, and I got to a part where basically I couldn't, there was no one left to heal, there was no, there was no, there were no more events. I had done everything, but I hadn't leveled my character up in the right manner. But if you play this game and you do all the events and you do everything you need to do, then before you do the final quest, then you're gonna be all right through this game. And hard mode isn't really even as hard as a Souls game. So that's pretty much it for this episode of Game Time. This is your host, Tom, signing off from 734 Games, where gaming is alive.
Ultraviolet curtains and orichalcum powder. Dr. Swansea's always been a resourceful bastard. I bet he never told you he had this installed in case of a vampire attack. Says a lot about how much he trusts you.
What have you done with Edgar?
Don't worry. We don't kill humans.